Hi, this is Krishna. If you are going to learn Shishar, then you have chosen right video. Because in Shishar, everything is objects and classes. Let us try to understand what is an object and a class. What you have seen around you is an object. Every object has some properties and methods. Here, car is an object and car has four wheels. And every car has four wheels. This is the common property of the car. In the same way, bird has two wings and every bird has two wings. So this is the common property of bird. Panditji can do puja and every Panditji can do puja. So this is the common function of Panditji. So depending on their similar properties and methods, objects are classified into classes. So technically we can say class is a container for common properties and methods of similar object. If we are talking about Brahmins class, Brahmins are related to collection of Pandit. So every Pandit have some common fields and functions like ID, name, puja, bhajan, etc. Here, Brahmins class is a container for holding some common fields and functions like Pandit 1. Pandit 1 has common field like ID and Pandit 2 has same field. So this is ID the common for Pandit 1, Pandit 2 and Pandit 3 also. So these are all common fields of the Pandit. In the same way, name field is the common for all objects. Puja is a common function to all Pandits. So these are all common properties and functions of Brahmin class. Okay. We can apply these common fields and functions to a specific object by creating an instance of a class. Like, I create an instance of this Brahmins class. So this is an object. How object is created? So this is the way of creating an object. Brahmins is the class name and Pandit 1 is the object of this Brahmins class equal to new keyword, then Brahmins two parentheses at the end semicolon. So this Pandit 1 object has ID property, name and puja. So these are all coming from this Brahmins class. So Brahmin class has common properties and common methods. So every class has some properties and methods and events also. So we can achieve those using objects. So object is the key point to access the elements of a class. So we practically understand the class and objects. Here I am creating one class using system namespace. So class Brahmin Brahmin. So I create a Brahmin class. This class contains some fields. These fields like public integer, Pandit ID, public string Pandit name, public string Pandit Puja Geet. So this class has three fields, and I create one more method, or you can say function. So functions and methods both are interchangeably using public void pandit details. So this is the method. Using this method, we call the details of Pandit. So you can print console dot write line. Pandit ID. So this is the placeholder to hold these fields. Okay. Then Pandit name. Again placeholder. This is one. So Pandit ID, comma Pandit name. So these two fields are stored in this placeholder. So Pandit ID is stored in this placeholder, and Pandit name is stored in this placeholder. Okay. I create one more method. Public void Puja. Console dot write line. So Puja placeholder. So this class has, class Brahmin has three fields and two methods. So one method is Pandit details, it picks Pandit details, and second method is Puja. And this class has some three fields. Okay, so I can run these fields. I want to create one more class program. So every program must be one main method that should be static void main. So this is the main method. This is the entry point of any program. So every program must have a main method. It is the entry point of any program, any application. So if Program is there, so method, main method must be there. Okay, so how I can call this class, Brahmin class here. How to create a Brahmin class? Brahmin class name, then object name. Suppose Pandit 1 equal to new Brahmin. So Pandit 1 is the object of Brahmin class. So using this object, I can use properties and methods of this Brahmin class. So how can I use this? Pandit ID, so equal to 1. Pandit 1 dot Pandit name equal to Subramanyam. Subramanyam and Pandit 1 dot Puja Git equal to some gifts, something like Hare Ram, Hare Krishna, Hare Ram, Hare Krishna. Okay. So I call these details from Pandit 1 dot Pandit details. Pandit details. Okay. So Pandit 1 dot Puja. So I call the Puja method also. So this is the way of calling objects, can say creating an objects and calling the methods like this. So I want to create one more object. I want to create one more Pandit. So I just copy this thing and paste it here and make it 2. Again 2 2 2 2 2. So Pandit ID is 2 here. Name of the Pandit name is Ramakrishna, and Puja Git is Jai Ganesha. So I have two objects, Pandit 1 and Pandit 2. So if I print this, it will be merged. So I just make a differentiate here. I create one more console dot write line. I make a straight line here so that it will be looking more clear. And I make it new line. So backward slash n makes new line. This is looks this is works as a enter key in your keyboard. Okay, so try to run this program and see the output. By pressing Control F5, you can see the result. So excellent. Pandit ID 1, Pandit name Subramanyam, Puja Hare Ram Hare Krishna. Pandit ID 2, Pandit name Ramakrishna, Puja Jai Ganesh. So I have a class named Brahmin, and this class contains some fields and methods. This class contains two methods. I run these two methods and properties using by creating instance of a class. So this is the way of using classes and objects. Okay, thank you guys. For more videos, please subscribe my channel and click on thumbs button.